If psychology is the most important one, by inference, it means you need to show your character in action. You need to show how they behave. Now, how do you do that? You don't have them do anything random. What do I mean by that? Opening a scene and a character is doing something, whatever, you know, riding their bike or scolding their child or whatever. That in itself is not interesting. The most interesting way of learning about a character is seeing their response to an event. How does a character respond to what happens to them? All drama works in terms of events, what happens to a character, and actions, the response of that character to that event. And how people respond differently to events is how you can define their character. You say the same thing to Joe Biden or Donald Trump, you will get two different answers most likely, I would say. And the difference is in their character. So you confront them with an event. It's in the action that you get to know the character, how they respond to the event. So when you set up your character, you ideally you want to create an event. You want to create a strong event, an interesting, exciting, sometimes dramatic, traumatic event, and then see how that character is going to respond to it. If your character is going to respond to that event like we all would, you're going to cut the scene, or you're going to cut the character. You may even have to cut the whole story because it means it's not interesting. You want to show how your character is unique, how your character is different from anyone else. If you struggle to do that, you really need to think hard about who this character really is. Because in order for a character to be worthy for the screen, you want to see them do things differently from other people, other characters that we've seen on the screen before. So characters, action, action in response to events, events that are interesting, that are exciting, that are worthy of screen time.